Hello everyone, and thanks Gary for having me on the show. You have been asking me to participate to the show for many years, and now it's finally happening, so it's great to be here. So I'm not sure if I'm able to be in the live chat today, because we recently got a new baby to the family, so I'm very busy right now, but at least I'm hoping to be in the live chat for a little while, so that I can participate to the conversation and maybe answer to your questions. But sitting here in the garage is quite boring, so let's go out. Okay, so today I want to talk about what it's like to be a Velonaut. So I have prepared for you a list of top 5 best things about being a Velonaut. And actually there's quite a lot of good things about being a Velonaut. So much, in fact, that I had difficulties to decide which one I should include to this top 5 list. Because there are things like efficiency, meaning that I'm always faster than roadies. Also, one other thing which didn't make to the list. We Velonauts, we don't have to buy expensive fuel for our Velomobiles. And that's especially important now, when the oil prices are pretty high. And that one of course should have been on the list, but there are also so many other things. Well, maybe we can talk about those things in the live chat and in the video comments later. But anyway, now let's get into my list. Okay, so on the 5th place, well, this thing actually, this applies to all cycling, so not just Velomobiles, but especially with Velomobiles this is very important, because when you have a Velomobile, you tend to ride more, because it's so much fun to ride a Velomobile. So on the 5th place on my list, Velonauts, they are always in good shape, because they are cycling a lot. Because by riding a Velomobile, you end up doing some free exercise, so this is a very healthy way of transportation, not like sitting in a car and doing nothing. With Velomobile you get very good exercise, and because this is so fun, you do this more often, so yeah, this is very good for you. Okay, the next thing on the list, you can basically wear anything you like. So for example, road cyclists, they always have some kind of weird codes about what to wear and so on. And then they need to have very aerodynamic clothes, because those road bikes, those are so inefficient. And also, it's a good idea to wear something bright colors, so you are more visible. But by running a Velomobile, you don't have to worry about any of those things, because you are here inside the Velomobile, so you can wear whatever you like, or even be completely naked. And no one will see. So no need to try to wear aerodynamic clothes. You can just wear whatever you feel is the most comfortable. Let's continue this comparison between Velomobiles and upright bikes. Riding a Velomobile is much more safer than riding an upright bike. Let me explain. Okay, first of all, you are much closer to the ground. So if you happen to fall, you don't fall from very high. Also, there's this Velomobile body around you, so if you happen to crash, this will protect you. Usually when upright cyclists crash or fall, they do hurt themselves pretty badly. And that's why they are usually wearing helmet, because, yeah, that probably will save their lives. But if you happen to crash with a Velomobile, you probably can walk away with only few minor bruises, because there's this protective body around you. Luckily, I haven't crashed my Velomobile yet, so I don't know what kind of experience that is. But I've seen some Velomobile crashes on the internet, and while the Velomobiles always look pretty bad after the crash, but the Velonauts themselves, they usually don't hurt themselves so badly. So yeah, Velomobiles are pretty safe. Hey, where's my Velomobile? What kind of Velonaut am I? Leaving my Velomobile behind like that. Also, Velomobiles usually have pretty bright colors and good lights, so they are also very visible, as you can see. Very bright colors. I'm sure you can see this kind of thing from very far away, so no need to wear any bright and colorful clothes like upright cyclists have to. Okay, so now we have talked about how the Velomobile body protects you from the crash. So yeah, being a Velonaut is much more safer than being an upright cyclist. But then also this Velomobile body, this protects you from the weather. Oi, perkules! Oi, perkules! Luckily, I'm riding a Velomobile. With open frame bike, I would be completely wet. So if it's bad weather, like it's raining or it's cold or something like that, that doesn't matter. So, as a Velonaut, you are not afraid of bad weather, because you will stay dry here inside the Velomobile if it's raining, and you will stay warm here if it's cold outside. Then also this Velomobile body protects you from direct sunlight, so you don't burn yourself. So basically you are in shade while you are inside the Velomobile. And as long as you keep moving, there will be enough airflow inside the Velomobile, so that the temperature doesn't rise much warmer than outside. I don't usually have to worry about it being too hot inside the Velomobile, because look at this. It's still winter here. We have still about half a meter of snow. But yeah, this is early March when I'm shooting this video. So when this is coming out, probably next month, then I think we already have good velomobile conditions, because this is not very nice. The roads are still in pretty bad condition around here. Okay then, the number one on my list, and I think this is one of the best things about being a Velonaut. You don't constantly have to be washing the drivetrain like you have to do with a regular bike. When you ride in the weather like this, like we have here now, let me show you. Okay, so with open frame bike, after a ride in the conditions like this, you really need to wash the drivetrain after the ride if you want it to work the next day. Trust me, I've ridden my open frame bikes in the conditions like this, and it's not fun. And the washing the bike after the ride, it's not fun either. So yeah, this is definitely the best thing about being a Velonaut, because I don't have to wash the drivetrain after every ride, because the drivetrain is completely enclosed inside the velomobile body, so it doesn't get dirty. Definitely the best thing about being a Velonaut. But not everything about being a Velonaut are great things. So that's why I have prepared you a list of top 5 worst things about being a Velonaut. And let's start this list with farts. I'm sure you all have done that. Farting inside a velomobile, it's not very fun. With open frame bikes, and especially with upright bikes, if you fart, the smell is going to be the problem for the guy behind you. But if you fart inside the velomobile, the smell is your problem. The smell has to go somewhere, and usually there's a little bit airflow inside the velomobile, and the smell, it will escape usually through the manhole, because yeah, there's this big opening and your head and your nose is in the middle of that opening, so all the smell, it's coming straight to your nose. So yes, that's definitely one of the worst things about being a Velonaut. Farting inside the velomobile, not fun. Then as a Velonaut, you of course enjoy cruising with fast speed on flat road, but climbing, that's not fun. Because then after that fast cruising, you suddenly end up riding as slow as other upright cyclist, or maybe even slower, or then you have to output as much or maybe even more power as the upright cyclist to keep up with them. So yeah, that's not very fun. And also if you're climbing in hot climate, then there will be pretty hot inside the velomobile, because you are not moving very fast, so there will be not enough airflow to keep the air moving inside the velomobile, so the temperature will rise pretty fast. Then when you stop somewhere, there's usually a lot of people asking questions, so that might get pretty annoying sometimes. Like for example, if you stop for a break to some cafe or something, there will be always a lot of people asking about questions about your velomobile, and your short 10-minute break may stretch up into 30 minutes or 45 minutes or something like that. So you usually have to reserve some extra time for the other people and to answering their questions. Sometimes that just gets pretty annoying. Then sometimes it's pretty difficult to decide where I should ride with this velomobile, because basically, well, not maybe not in winter, but usually velomobile is way too fast for cycle paths, because velomobiles are so efficient that these are much more faster than other type of bicycles. And around here, the bike paths, they are usually combined bike paths and sidewalks, so there will be people riding bikes and walking their dogs, so there will be all kinds of people on those paths. Riding with velomobile around 40 kilometers per hour on that kind of bike path, it's not always very safe, even though I always try to do it safely. But then on the other hand, velomobiles are usually too slow for regular roads. Well, not always. For example, here in the village, the speed limit is 40 kilometers per hour, so I can always keep up with other traffic. Well, not in winter, but in summer I can. But anyway, in basically, sometimes it feels that Velonauts doesn't belong to anywhere, because we are too slow for roads and too fast for bike paths. So where the hell should we go? So that is sometimes very annoying, trying to decide where to ride. And then we get to the last point on my list of top 5 worst things about being Velonaut. And that is that, well, I didn't come up with anything else. So so yeah, that's the last thing. There's not enough things to make a top 5 list of worst things about being Velonaut. Well, actually there probably is a lot more negative things about being a Velonaut. So feel free to discuss these things in the in the live chat. And now, I would like to hear what other panel members have to say about this. What's your best and worst things about being a Velonaut? But okay, I think that's all I have to say today. It was very nice to be here. Thanks again for having me. And now, back to you, Gary.